That's a good start, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's not an easy starting.
I know, I'm so sorry.
Starting question.
Est-ce qu'on peut justifier la guerre par la mise en place de la démocratie?
I don't think so, and I think it's because there have been way too many instances where democracies have been forcefully instilled, and it has completely messed with the culture and the political system that the country has always known, that the people have always known. Because at the end of the day, it is a Western idea, and it's not always compatible with cultures that are different from it. So I don't think that the answer is simply to enforce a democracy by means of deciding for someone, but rather to assess what culturally and politically can be fitting for someone's environment, for the values that someone has always known, and see what fits best, because there are many people who believe in following a certain system the way that it is, following authoritarianism, and it's a belief, and they function better like that. So I think the answer is much deeper, and you need to go into understanding really where the people come from and how they think.
Qu'on pèse ça et qu'on met ça en balance sur une démocratie qui peut être très fragile, qui peut tenir quelques années, qui peut être à l'origine de montée d'extrémisme. Finalement, le jeu n'en vaut pas la chandelle et vaut mieux toujours rester dans la discussion. Et finalement, on peut arriver à la démocratie par autre chose que finalement par une guerre qui serait peut-être trop meurtrière et trop violente pour finalement un résultat qui serait très fragile.
I suppose there have to be some cases where war is justified, where forceful action needs to be taken for a greater good. I suppose, I mean, an example of that would be a regime which is doing morally reprehensible things, mm-hmm. which, you know, at some point somebody has got to stop and say, you know, irrespective of what value system you're a part of,
right.
somebody has got to say, this can't happen, you can't, you know, murder your own citizens
right.
in the streets
right.
or those sorts of things.
Non, je pense pas qu'il faut faire la guerre pour arriver à une démocratie, non.
Non, je pense pas. Je pense que la guerre, ça fait partie de la nature de l'homme, mais que la démocratie, c'est un concept qui s'est imposé dans certaines contrées du monde, mais qui n'a rien à voir avec la culture, avec l'histoire.
See, that's a very complex question, and it requires a convoluted answer. Because in one instance, one could argue that democracy is the most fair system. However, by you doing that, you are imposing your own beliefs on another culture, right? And if you're a cultural relativist, that means is that you can't. Each culture is happy in their own way, and it's unjust. Well, it's unjust for you to just impose your own kind of culture if you believe yours is better, because then you're just being a supremacist. You're not necessarily being a peace person. So to answer your question, I'm inclined to say no, because democracy isn't necessarily the best one, right? I mean, democracy has a component of capitalism, and capitalism has its own downfalls about it. Even though it's the most stable one, it has the most downfalls. Well, it also has some downfalls too. So I'm not sure if that answers your question. I just find it a very hard question to answer.
Absolutely.